The Philippine Anti-Graft Court junks the 276 million peso worth for feature case against the Marcoses. The October 4 decision granted the motion to dismiss filed by Imelda Marcos and the estate of the late former President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The Sandigambayan said there was a violation of the defendant's right to a speedy disposition of their case, adding it dismissed the 37-year-old case due to inordinate delay. The Presidential Commission on Good Government filed a complaint in 1987 seeking to recover 276 million pesos worth of funds and properties that were allegedly amassed during the 20-year presidency of Marcos Sr. Economic-related concerns now on top of Filipino voters' minds for the 2025 midterm elections, so suggests a new Pulse Asia survey commissioned by the think tank Strat-based ADR Institute. Now, some 57% of the 1,200 respondents said they want Senate bets to improve job creation and investment-led growth. Polled voters said fighting corruption is also a must, followed by quality health care and education. Strat-based group CEO Dindo Manhit says prioritizing investments will also help the country recover quickly from disruptions. The Pulse Asia survey ran from September 6th to the 13th, with margin of error at 3 percentage points. Some 184 individuals filed their candidacy for the Senate race next year. The growth in the Philippines' manufacturing output slows in August. According to data from the Philippine Statistics Authority, the results of the latest monthly integrated survey of selected industries showed the value of production index expanded by 1.8%, slower than the 6.4% growth seen in July. The PSA attributes this to the slower annual growth rate in the manufacture of food products, as well as of computer and electronic products. The growth of the volume of production also slowed to 2.8% from 6.8% in July.
Jamie Dimon, CEO of JP Morgan, not yet decided on whether to endorse a U.S. presidential candidate. In an interview with Bloomberg, Dimon said he will vote and he is still considering his public stance. JP Morgan recently clarified his neutral position after Donald Trump claimed on social media that Dimon had endorsed the Republican candidate. This adds another chapter to the complicated relationship between Trump and Dimon, who previously clashed during Trump's presidency. Trump called Dimon a highly overrated globalist last year. Then he said in June he'd consider Dimon for Treasury Secretary, only to refute that weeks later. Double Dragon is launching a retail bonds program worth 30 billion pesos. Committee directors approved the shelf registration of the bonds to be issued in tranches in the next 2 years. Citing lower interest rates, it expects the retail bonds to have an 8% rate per annum for 2024, all the way to 6% in 2026. Double Dragon is a joint venture between Ed Garcia II and Jollibee Food Corporation's Tony Tan Cactio. Next, the City Core Renewable Energy Corporation, it's releasing in advance the proceeds from its initial public offering this year. C-REC says the amount of 1.2 billion pesos will help ramp up the development of its solar energy plants. And speaking of IPOs, fuel retailer Topline secures regulatory approval for its public offering. The IPO is valued at 2.87 billion pesos. That'll be for 3.7 billion shares at 78 centavos apiece. Target offer period is from November 6 to 12, with stock exchange listing on the 22nd. Topline will become the fourth IPO at the local bourse this year.